Shalom, everyone. Giving all praises to the Most High, Elohim, and His Word and His Truth. It's your boy, Gdash the Prophet. I am back with another exclusive movie breakdown. This is Bird Box. Many of y'all have been waiting for me to break this thing down. Well, guess what? It is here now. So, without further ado, let's just get straight into it. But I do like to start off with some scriptures so we can get some understanding, because this is a spiritual movie. So I want to start here in the book of Enoch to get some background information on these things, right? So we're going to start with Enoch chapter 15. We're going to read verses 8 and 10. And now the giants who are produced from the spirit and flesh shall be called evil spirits upon earth, and on the earth shall be their dwelling. Okay, evil spirits shall proceed from their bodies, and this is how we got these evil spirits roaming the earth today. Okay, because they are born from men, and from the holy watchers is their beginning and primal origin. They shall be evil spirits on earth. Okay, these evil spirits that come from the bodies of these giants. Okay, and evil spirits shall they be called. Okay, as for the spirits of heaven, okay, in heaven shall be their dwelling. But as for the spirits of the earth, which were born upon the earth, on earth shall be their dwelling. Okay, so these evil spirits come from the flesh of these giants. Okay, and this is why in a book of Ephesians chapter 6 and 12, it says, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places." Okay, dealing with these evil spirits that are roaming the earth right now. So I just wanted to bring that out. All right. Now let's get it!
We have a place, a compound. We have a community. It's safe here. How many of you are there?
So now in this intro part, you hear the guy over the radio broadcasting saying, you know, we have a place, we have a compound, a community for people, basically a safe zone for people. Now there's two things going on with this part right here, or in this movie. But in this particular part, it is connected to the movie I Am Legend with Will Smith.
I am broadcasting on all AM frequencies. I will be at the South Street Seaport every day at midday when the sun is highest in the sky.
When he was broadcasting on the radio looking for survivors, all right, in this apocalyptic movie, just like in this film here, Bird Box, this is an apocalyptic movie.
Shelter. I can provide security.
So as we see here, this is the same similar theme. You know, Will Smith, he's trying to help any survivors in this apocalyptic movie here. Same thing going on in Bird Box, okay? End time scenario, end time situation here, broadcasting for any survivors. We see that.
Anybody out there, anybody, please, you are not alone.
Are any of them children? Because the fastest way to get here is by the river, and I don't think you could make it with kids.
Also, in this beginning intro scene, he's saying, you know, how many of you are there? You know, are any of you kids? Because, you know, the fastest way to get to this place is through this river, okay? And we know the river can be crazy. And he said, and if any of you are children, I don't think they can basically make it here if they are children, okay? Now, this is very symbolic. This intro scene here is very symbolic to the film, because to get to this place, I'm going to bring that out a little further on. But this place that they're trying to get to, because in the film you have two things going on. You have the normal film going on, and then you have them traveling along this river to get to this place. And this place is very symbolic, okay? Matter of fact, I'm just going to say it. This place is representing the kingdom of heaven to get to this place. And we know it's a rocky road. The river is very rocky, okay? Trying to make it to heaven can be really rocky. But to get there, you must be like a child. And not many people, especially grown adults, we are not going to humble ourselves like children in order to make it to the kingdom of heaven, which is what this place is representing in the film. But as I break down the movie, you're going to see, and it's all going to make sense, even though I gave it away already. Okay, but let's continue.
We are going on the trip now. It's going to be rough. It's going to feel like it's going on for a long time, so it's going to be hard to stay alert. It's going to be even harder to be quiet.
In this scene here where Sandra Bullock, she's talking to the children here, she's basically giving them instructions, right? She's giving them instructions. But I want to go to a scripture here on what we should be doing to our children in general. Proverbs chapter 22 and 6. Train up a child in the way he should go. In the way he should go. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. So it's important that we train up our children or instruct our children in the way that they should go. So when they get older, they will not depart from it. They don't understand this is the way. And the reason why we are destroyed today, because our children are lost. Okay? So
you have to do every single thing I say, or we will not make it. Understand?
Also, this particular part, she's instructing them just like how the Most High instructed Adam and Eve. Okay? And that's why they are called boy and girl, like Adam and Eve. Genesis chapter 1, verse 27. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. Okay, girl and boy, male and female. Okay, the Most High. So she's instructing them just like how the Most High instructed Adam and Eve at this part.
Under no circumstance are you allowed to take off your blindfold. If I find that you have, I will hurt you. Do you understand?
Here she said, under no circumstance are you to take off your blindfold. If I find out that you do, I'm going to hurt you. Okay? Just like the Most High, he gave Adam and Eve instructions and told them, if you do this, or if you do that, surely you will die. Okay? Same symbolic message here.
Boy, you have your dog. Girl, you have your kitty. This is just a place. There's nothing more that we need from it. Do you understand?
See that? She called them boy and girl. Okay, and then she said, this is just a place. It's nothing that we need from it. Okay, like this world. You know, this is just a place. We are just passing through. Of course, you know, we need food and clothing, essentials. Yeah, that's what she said. You have your blanket, your this and your that. But rather than that, you don't need much in this world. And this is why we know the devil is ruling, because the devil makes you think that you need this, you need that, you need that, gotta have that. We are under the devil's kingdom, okay? The USA, under Satan's authority. It is time to wake up. Oh, hello.
Never, ever take off your blindfold. If you look, you will die. Do you understand?
She told him, don't ever take off your blindfold. If you look, you will die. It's very important in the film, okay, very important in this movie, because once again, we are dealing with evil spirits on this earth who are in control of a lot of what we see, okay, and a lot of what we do. They are in control, because the people that are ruling the earth, they worship these entities. They're getting the knowledge, the wisdom, and information and technology from these entities, which is thus controlling us. So a lot of what we look at, what we do, once again, is coming from these evil spirits. We're dealing with an evil world, okay? That's why you must keep the blindfold on, but I will reveal more of that a little bit later.
Oh,
As you see, she put the birds in the box. Of course, the movie is called Bird Box. Why? Okay, once again, like I brought out in the beginning, this is a spiritual movie dealing with evil spirits, evil entities. And of course, animals are more sensitive to the spiritual world than a human, than a regular person. Okay, and that's why she's carrying the birds around in this box to sense when there are spiritual activity or paranormal activity around. Okay, you can find that in dogs and in many animals, okay, because they're more connected. We are not, and that's why we just do dumb stuff and it's just like, hey, whatever. All right, and we don't see the spiritual side of things.
Airports and train stations have shut down. Streets are crowded with people escaping cities by car and on foot as witnesses report unexplained mass suicide.
Now they said trains and airports have shut down. Okay, this is end time situation here.
Airports and train stations have shut down. Streets are crowded with people escaping cities by car and on foot.
These are the things that are coming and what they're planning for. Okay, airports and trains shut down, and then a bunch of mass suicides are going on right now. Okay, just peep that. Why is that? Why are people just killing themselves? Right?
Don't yet know what is causing the mass suicides in Europe and Russia. The eyewitness reports tell of people exhibiting psychotic behavior.
Once again, they don't know what is the cause of these mass suicides, okay? All these people just randomly killing themselves. This is a news broadcast here, but I will be bringing that out and showing that connection in just a little bit here. But we see what's going on, right? And once again, we know there are evil spirits roaming the earth.
So at 3 o'clock, I'm gonna go check out an Arabian stud. So at 3 o'clock, I'm gonna go check out an Arabian stud in Sausalito.
Oh, see, now that is a sentence you don't hear every day.
Now you see here, out of the blue, she says she's going to meet up with an Arabian stud. Why an Arabian stud? Out of all people, all nations, why an Arabian? As I showed y'all in my Mystery Babylon series, however, it's up right now online. Please check it out, part one, part two, and part three. And once again, if you want DVDs, inbox me on that. Okay, but you see here, she said an Arabian stud.
So at 3 o'clock, I'm gonna go check out an Arabian stud in Sausalito.
Why? Because they know where Mystery Babylon is, which is in Arabia, and I've explained that. I broke that down. Okay, the burden upon Babylon, by the desert, by the sea, the burden upon Arabia. They know where Mystery Babylon is. The Arabs are in control over the Europeans. Many people do not know that. Okay, they were showing that and proving that in the movie Robin Hood with Jamie Fox.
If we're to continue funding the Arabs, the money we owe them must sail in 4 days. We will have bought absolute power.
So you see here in the film Robin Hood, which this was another film I could have added or should have added to my Mystery Babylon breakdown. I think I brought out about maybe 35 movies. So this would probably make like 36. Okay, just to add, so this is like a bonus here. You see what he said, all right, about funding the Arabs, okay, and how they would have absolute power, okay? And they mentioned the Arabs over and over in this film.
A measure of hiring some special deputies, some of our most trusted crusaders. They're just back from Arabia.
So many different pockets, they were talking about the Arabs and how they're the devils and they're doing the devil's work and all of these type of things. So we see it right here, okay?
Oh my God, what the fuck is that?
What the fuck is what? What are you looking at? What did you see? What are you doing? Oh my God, Jess, don't do...
You see here in this part of the film, she's looking at something, she sees something, okay, and she's becoming demonically possessed, okay? She got demonically possessed, and then what does she do? She killed herself. She straight killed herself after seeing whatever she saw. Okay, whatever that was out there in the world, okay, that we don't see. She saw it, became possessed, and killed herself. Now, this is very important right here to the film, okay, and to us. And I want to make a connection in another film called The Fourth Kind.
Got Sarah, Timothy, and Joe lined up in the kitchen with a gun to their heads. We want to talk to you for some reason, all right?
Okay, so in this film, The Fourth Kind, which is based off a real-life story, okay, especially with all the real footage in it, you have this woman, she's a psychiatrist. She's also happened to be into hypnosis, which is like witchcraft. You know, a lot of people are into things that they don't know, which is demonic.
What's going on
here? I'm so sorry, but I gotta do this.
No, you have a choice, Tommy. We always have a choice.
Not this time.
Yeah.
However, the police, they call her up to the guy's crib because he has his family, his wife and his kids at gunpoint, ready to kill them for a reason, though, right?
I know.
So much.
But it's up at night. And if you saw what I saw, you would understand.
What did you see?
Now, you see right here, this is the crucial part. Pay attention to what he said. He said, I know what keeps us up at night. And if you saw what I saw, you would understand why he got this gun to his wife's head and his children hostage right now. Okay, that's something serious. This is real footage. This is for real. Okay, if you knew what keep us up at night, if you saw what I saw, just like here in this movie Bird Box, what she saw, if you saw what she saw and why she killed herself,
what I saw, you would understand.
What did you see, Tommy?
Then maybe you would understand that what we are seeing must be extremely evil. Whoa, that's real.
There's some Mabu eater. Some Mabu eater. What the hell does that mean?
What the hell does that mean?
I think I got the goddamn shot.
So at this point, he's asking her, what does this mean? Okay, this saying, I guess whenever this the entities pop up or whatever, they're making this chant or this seance or whatever, this saying that he's hearing, and he's asking her because she's a psychologist, maybe she might know the answer. What does this mean? But she can't help him at this point. You know, they're trying to calm him down, but she can't help him at this point. Okay, so so he ends up killing his family, shooting his wife, killing his children, and offing himself, okay? All because of what he saw.
Oh my God, what the fuck is that?
And if you saw what I saw, you would understand.
What did you
see? This evil, okay? If you saw what I saw, then you would understand, okay? Just like here in the film Bird Box, she saw what she saw. She was like, what the fuck is that? And then she ends up crashing. She couldn't control. She killed herself, just like he killed himself because of what he saw. This evil spirit, which had to be horrific enough for you to want to kill yourself. Okay? Bird Box exposed.
Sweetheart, get up right now.
Please don't go.
So as you see, she was trying to help Sandra Bullock, but this evil spirit, which is pretending to be her mom.
They talk to you so you can hear them, but...
They also talk inside your mind, like you're connected or something.
Mom? Please don't go.
Got her demonically possessed. Okay? She got caught up. Caught up. This is what's going on. All right, and a lot of us are demonically possessed and don't even know it, to tell you the truth.
Keep your eyes down. Keep your eyes down.
Now here, you see the brother comes in. Okay, the brother with the blue hoodie on. He comes to Sandra Bullock's aid and he tells her to keep your eyes down. Okay, keep your eyes down. All right, because we know these evil spirits are roaming the earth. Let's get a scripture here. Proverbs chapter 22, verse 3. A prudent man, like this brother here, foreseeth the evil, okay, and hideth himself. But the simple pass on and are punished, just like the woman that got caught up, you know, when a demon pretended to be her mom. Okay. And she killed herself. She passed on. Okay, so again, the prudent man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself. That's why he told her to keep her eyes down. But the simple pass on and are punished. And what happened? She jumped in the car, killed herself. She's dead. She passed on. Now, before I go any further, now that I introduced this brother here on the scene with the scriptures, I just want to confirm for you guys in a few movies, just to show you real lightly, that they know, quote unquote, black people, or what you call African Americans or Negroes, are the real biblical people, the real Jews, the real Hebrew Israelites of the scriptures. Hollywood knows that, and I'm going to show you in all these films, a few films, that they know this truth, this is what they do, and of course, in this film, Bird Box, I will also be showing that, okay?
You're not even American, you're not even African American, you're not even African American, you're not even African American.
You're not even African American.
Besides, to them... You're not even American. You're not even African American.
You are of the Igbo tribe, Bennett. You are of the Igbo tribe.
He that stealeth the man and selleth them.
Don't you?
He that stealeth the man and selleth them.
Don't you?
He that stealeth the man and selleth
them.
Or he be found in his hand, he's not going to be put to death.
You are of the Igbo tribe, Bennett. You are of the Igbo tribe. Igbo tribe.
This young man is the Igbo tribal leader. Do you understand what that means? This young man is the Igbo tribal leader. Do you understand what that means?
He was the tribal king. That makes him the heir to the Igbo nation. That makes him the heir to the Igbo nation. The Igbo nation.
Unaware of the rising tide of disobedience, of outright defiance, among the servant apes in our cities.
Mr. Governor, on investigation, many of the reported offenses have been proved minor.
That ape was killed while trying to escape from the city. That ape was killed while trying to escape from the city last night. That ape was killed while trying to escape from the city last night.
That makes him the heir to the Igbo nation.
That ape was killed while trying to escape from the city last night.
That makes him the heir to the Igbo nation.
That ape was. That ape was. That ape was. That ape was. That ape was.
We are still God's chosen.
You know, I am the chosen one.
We are still God's chosen.
You know, I am the chosen one.
I'll be honest with you. I don't like the cult. I don't think much of Hebrews either.
That makes him the heir to the Ebo Nation.
I'll be honest with you. I don't like the cult. I don't think much of Hebrews either.
That makes him the heir to the Ebo Nation.
I thought Jews were supposed to be smart. Jews sound just like the Negro.
That makes him the heir to the Ebo Nation.
I thought Jews were supposed to be smart. Jews sound just like the Negro.
That makes him the heir to the Ebo Nation.
You Italian, you Jew. I mean, what are you? You can't make up your mind.
Me?
Yeah, you.
I'm from the lost black tribe of Israel, the Yos. I'm from the lost black tribe of Israel, the Yos.
That makes him the heir to the Ebo Nation.
The lost tribes of Israel were black.
That makes him the heir to the Ebo Nation.
You a child of God. You got purpose. It's in you. The law put it there, and there ain't nothing nobody can do to take it away.
Kill me. Purge. You're a son of God. You're a son of God. You're a son of God.
That makes him the heir to the Ebo Nation.
I'm the only normal person left around here. I'm a black Jew. I can't read. I'm half drunk. I'm a black Jew. I'm a black Jew.
That makes him the heir to the Ebo Nation.
And he accepts me. I'm Jewish. I'm Jewish. I'm Jewish.
Do you know that the black man in America is Israel? That he's Jews. Do you know that?
Yes.
That makes him the heir to the Ebo Nation.
No, the only thing that will happen soon is we're all gonna die soon. This has a classic biowarfare signature, North Korea or...
Now, in this scene, he said the only thing that's gonna happen soon is they're all gonna die soon. And then he says this has a classic, okay, which he really means scriptural, okay, biowarfare signature. And he mentions North Korea and all of that, okay? Which basically means nuclear destruction is prophesied, okay? It's prophesied here. So they're telling you what it is, but let's go here into the scriptures to confirm what he's saying. Malachi chapter 4 and verse 1. For behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven. And all the proud, yeah, and all that do wickedly shall be stubble, gonna burn, okay? They're all gonna die soon, okay?
The only thing that will happen soon is we're all gonna die soon.
Shall be stubble, and the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Most High, okay, of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch. And that's what he said. The only thing that's going to happen soon is they're all going to die soon. And then he mentions this classic biowarfare thing, which means nuclear destruction. And there's more scriptures on that, but let's keep it moving.
My crew saw one.
What?
One minute we were digging a foundation, and then my contractor just lies down in front of the bulldozer. And then
Now, the brother here that I showed y'all, or that I was telling y'all, who's playing Christ in this film, okay, he said his crew saw one.
My crew saw one.
Okay, and one of his contractors laid down in front of the bulldozer. But he said his crew. Now, as I said, he's playing Christ. So, who is his crew? The disciples. Okay? The disciples. But let's continue and see what he says.
And then my operator tips the rig into the ditch and snaps his own neck.
Then he says his operator tips the rig over and snaps his own neck. Okay? Basically, killed himself. Okay? So, him being a disciple, I mean, him being playing Christ and his crew being the disciples, and then you have this one individual who snaps his own neck or whatever, okay? Let's go into scriptures here. This reminds me of the scriptures, Matthew chapter 27, verses 3 and 5. Then Judas, which had betrayed him, talking about the Christ, okay, the Mashiach, when he saw that he was condemned, repented himself and brought again the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and elders. And he cast down the pieces of silver in the temple and departed and went and hanged himself. Okay. And you see here, he said he snapped his own neck. Okay.
Into the ditch and snapped his own neck.
There you go. Him playing Christ, his crew, the disciples, and one of them killed themselves, snapped their neck. Judas happened to have hanged himself. Interesting. Yeah.
The president has declared a state of emergency and has closed all borders. Do not go outside. Avoid social media.
So here in the scene, on the news, they declared a state of emergency. Okay, the president declared a state of emergency, which means martial law. Okay, lockdown. And then it says to avoid all social media. Okay, so this whole state of emergency, martial law, it connects to the movie Under Siege, where they were showing martial law coming in.
Debating the president's call for martial law. We have in this country a tradition of invoking martial law only when the most dire of circumstances require.
The president has declared a state of emergency and has closed all borders.
Today, with the invocation of the War Powers Act by the president, I am declaring a state of martial law in this city.
Because, of course, I showed y'all in many of my other films that this is what the government wants to do. Okay, bring in martial law. Also, this connects to the movie Crazies, okay, with the military coming in.
Today, with the invocation of the War Powers Act by the president, I am declaring a state of martial law in this city.
This is what martial law is, and they're showing this over and over in many films. Even the other movie with Jamie Foxx called Robin Hood, like I just showed y'all previously, they were mentioning martial law. Okay, martial law.
People.
Let him come back and kill us all. I am not running. Come back and kill us all. I am not running.
The city is in lockdown. It is martial law. The city is in lockdown. It is martial law. The city is in lockdown. It is martial law. The city is in lockdown, it is martial law.
Gonyo, this is not a gang.
It's like a goddamn army.
No, this is some straight bullshit. That's a fucking militia.
you really think war between the black race and the white race is inevitable?
Let me tell you, arm yourself, brother. Get ready, because the revolution is coming. Pick up a gun and arm yourself. Pick up a gun and arm yourself. Because trust me, it's coming.
But let's get it in the scriptures here. 2 Esdras chapter 16, verse 70 to 73. For there shall be in every place and in the next cities a great insurrection upon those that fear the Most High. Okay? They shall be like madmen, sparing none. That's going to be the military acting like madmen. Okay? But still spoiling and destroying those that fear the Most High. Okay? For they shall waste and take away their goods and cast them out of their houses. See, that's martial law. That's what they can do when they enact martial law. And as we see, it is here in the scriptures. Okay. Then shall they be known who are my chosen. So you see that at this time, that's when people are going to know who's God's chosen. Because when they roll up on God's people, that's when the Most High is going to react, because we are going to need to cry out to our God, and he's going to deliver us from the hand of our enemies, which is written also in the scriptures. And they shall be tried as the gold in the fire. You see that? So that means nobody really knows who's the Most High's people at this point. Everybody's thinking it's the Jewish man, so-called Jewish man. But as we see right here in the scripture, it's confirming when this happens, when this takes place, then there shall be known who is the Most High's chosen at this time. So that's telling you that the Most High's chosen are those whom they are coming for. All right, it's time to wake up.
What the shit is happening?
It's the end game, man.
Huh?
I'm sorry, what?
The end game. Humanity has been judged and we've been found wanting.
Judged by who?
So here in this scene, the brother, heavyset brother, that played in the movie Get Out, he's telling them, you know, it's the end game. The end game. Okay, what's the end game? He said humanity has been judged, right? Which also connects to another film, okay, The Mist. And when the white lady was telling them about the end times, she was reading the scriptures. Okay, reading the scriptures and talking about the end times. The end times have come.
This has all been written. The end time has come.
The end game.
What are you proposing?
That we all prepare to meet our maker.
Okay, it's time to meet the maker. Okay? Connection right here.
And he is a stern and vengeful God. And we have been mocking him far too long, and now he demands retribution in blood.
Also connecting to the first Purge movie that I exposed, okay, where the brother was talking about a blood baptism, talking about that's what the doctor ordered, and he was pointing up to the sky, pointing up to the Most High.
A blood baptism. See, that's what the doctor ordered.
And he is a stern and vengeful God, and we have been mocking him far too long, and now he demands retribution in blood.
Blood baptism.
Read the good book. It calls for expiation. Blood.
What?
Blood.
Blood baptism.
So these filmmakers, they have a great sense or a great idea of spiritual things and about the Most High and the end times and what's coming. Even though everybody's walking around like nothing is going to happen, they have a great idea of this.
They go by different names, right? You got world religion and mythology that's full of mentions of demons or spirit creatures. People who's actually seen these creatures almost always describe the encounter.
So now, here he is talking about demons and spirit creatures. Now, y'all know in the beginning, I started it off with the book of Enoch and Ephesians showing you about these evil spirits, okay, these demons that are roaming the earth, okay, going to and fro, that proceeded forth from the bodies of these giants, okay? And that this is what we battle against every day, not against the flesh and blood, but against the evil spirits that dwell in people and that are walking this earth, okay?
Worst fears or your deepest sadness or your greatest loss.
That sounds like bullshit to me, man. That's religious talk.
It's not bullshit, okay? It's real talk, it's fact.
Now, notice how they have the European guy right there saying it sounds like BS. And he's like, it's not BS, it's real talk, it's facts. Okay, I'm going to show y'all something now, what they're trying to do here with this scene. Okay, just notice that. They had the European man say it sounds like BS. Okay, and here, this is a brother here dropping this truth. A brother. Not the European man that's dropping this truth and that's saying this, but a brother with this particular knowledge. Peep that now.
Come in all different forms, right? You got the Akamana, you got the Varios Devas from ancient Zoroastrian legend. You got the Surgot from ancient Christian occult beliefs.
So he's mentioning these creatures and things, you know, and where they come from, he says, they come from the Surgot, they come from ancient Christian occult beliefs, okay? Talking about the scriptures. Okay, but notice how they call it ancient Christian occult beliefs, okay? And you know, the news media is always attacking the Hebrew Israelites saying that we're a cult because we use the scriptures, okay? Anything that is dealing with the Most High coming from the scriptures, they're going to call it a cult. Even though they have their churches and they set up their churches all over and they push their false religions on everybody, they're calling this a cult.
You got the Puka from Celtic mythology. All different names, but the same thing.
And what's that?
The end of us.
Now, after explaining all of that, he said, so what does that mean? And he says, the end of us. The end of us, okay? The end game. The end of us, which goes back to the movie The Mist, okay? When she says, the end time has come. Okay, the truth is coming out because guess what, guys? The spiritual world is more real than this physical world we live in. Okay, because we are a spirit. All right, we are a spirit, and the spiritual world is more real than this physical. Because after your physical body dies, it becomes a spirit. Just like I showed you in the beginning, once again, okay, the spirits from the giants that proceeded from them shall be called evil spirits upon earth. All right?
Did you learn all of that working at the supermarket?
No, I've been just studying it for years.
In college?
Not college per se, but I mean the internet. I mean, it's where you get all your information from.
Now, this is the part here that stands out, okay? You have this brother here, okay, that, like I said, played in the movie Get Out, all right? Now, you notice what she asked him, okay? She said, did you learn all of that while working in the supermarket, right? Then he said, nah, I've just been studying that for years. And then she said, did you learn that in college? And he's like, no, you know, he got it basically from the internet. All right, now you have to notice what these filmmakers are doing, trying to basically assassinate black folks, quote unquote black folks, that are waking up with this particular knowledge to make fun of them. Okay, this is very symbolic right here, what she's doing. Okay, very symbolic, but I'm going to show you in two other films how they are subliminally attacking quote-unquote black folks who are awakening, because they know there's a spiritual awakening amongst quote-unquote black people. So this is how Hollywood is now attacking them, making them look like they are ignorant, they are stupid for coming out with this information. Okay, just want y'all to notice that, but I'm going to show it in another film. Now we're going to go to Get Out, and I'm going to show you how this same brother here, they did the same thing in that film. had him speaking some truth, some facts, but yet they laughed at him.
Look, what I'm about to tell you gonna sound crazy. I believe they've been abducting black people, brainwashing them, making them work for them as sex slaves and shit.
So you see here in the movie Get Out, okay, he was playing a TSA officer, and he went to the police station and trying to basically talk about his missing friend. And he's saying, the first thing he said is, I'm going to tell you something crazy. Remember, these people write the script, okay? Tell you something crazy. So, of course, they got to put that in your mind that what he's saying is crazy. He's crazy. And he says he believed that they've been abducting black people and making them sex slaves and whatnot.
Making them okay? Work for them as sex slaves and shit.
Setting them up. Setting y'all up, okay? Assassinating people's character, okay? But let's keep going.
I don't know if it's the hypnosis that's making them slaves or whatnot. But all I know is they already got two brothers we know.
Now here he says, I don't know if it's the hypnosis that's making them slaves. But, you know, basically all I know is they got two brothers already, right? Now, peep what he said. I don't know if it's the hypnosis. Okay, what are we being hypnotized by? Think about that. Television, media, radio. That's making us slaves to the system. Mentally, spiritually. That's how we being hypnotized. You hearing that song over and over and over. And it's dumb as hell. Talking about killing your own people. Robbing your own people. Bees and holes and all of that. And look, that's what we become. That's what we idolize. So, thus we are hypnotized by this foolishness. Because before it was positive rap. We had the real rap. Okay? We had deep thoughts then. So, again, what are we being hypnotized by?
There could be a whole bunch of brothers they got already. What's the next move?
So as he sat there and tried to tell them, you know, this stuff he's been researching and so forth and so on, they sat there and laughed at him. And she brought the two other cops in there, because first he was speaking to her. Then she brought the two other cops in there with her to laugh, to just laugh at the brother. Now, this is his own kind. Mind you, this is his own people here. Okay, another sister, another brother. Okay. Here to laugh at him. That's like when we tell, when we share our truth with brothers and sisters out there, they might end up laughing, okay, sharing this truth. But once again, they laughed at him kicking this knowledge, okay, just like in Bird Box. He was dropping the knowledge and the guy was like, this is BS. Or, you know, she's like, well, did you learn that while you was in working at the supermarket? And then she's like, well, did you learn that in college? Okay, because this is how crafty these devils are to assassinate our character when we wake up with this knowledge and this information that's not known to the masses of people, that's not being taught to the masses. So the masses don't know this information. So when we speak on this hidden information, it's funny. It's a joke here.
And don't ever say that I don't do nothing for you.
So you see here, it's all jokes. So all fun and games is all jokes on the so-called Negro that's waking up with this information and knowledge, who's now awakening himself. But let's go to another film to show you once again, this is what Hollywood is doing, okay? Those that make these films, that have all this money, that have all this hidden knowledge, they are making fun of us in this subliminal way. So once again, when we start sharing this truth with the world will in turn look at us as just a joke. Okay, he's just talking BS. All right, but here's another example in this movie, Night School with Kevin Hart.
I first got woke when I seen Terminator, and I realized it wasn't just a movie. It was prophecy. First identified by the 3.5%ers.
So notice what he's saying here. He first became woke. Get it? We awakening, all right? He first became woke when he saw the movie Terminator, okay? And he realized that it wasn't just a movie, like this Bird Box. here, okay? It's not just a movie. It's more than a movie here. These people are dropping subliminal messages in these films with hidden truth and hidden knowledge, okay? That's what we need to understand. That's why I expose films, movies, and etc. Because it's not just a movie. It is a message and a subliminal message to those who may not know this information or may have this information. But it's for us to wake up. But notice, as he's talking, they're looking at him. They're looking around in the classroom like, this guy is kind of nuts here. But look what he's saying again. This attack on quote-unquote black people waking up.
Let's just put it like this. The revolution will not be roboticized. Mm-hmm. Not on Jay's watch. Real nigga shit.
Message, right. The revolution will not be roboticized or televised, okay? Because once things pop off, martial law and all of that, they're going to cut your TV. They ain't going to be showing what they need to be shown on television, okay? When it goes down the way it's supposed to go down, when the revolution begins, when military run up on everybody, okay? Ain't going to be no cameras, huh? Ain't going to be no cameras. And that's what he's saying here. Think about that one.
That's what I'm talking about. That's Illuminati. That's what I'm saying. It's like they watching you and you think you watching them. That's what they do.
Again, you see that? He jumped up and said, that's Illuminati, because he knows that's what a lot of us are talking about, exposing the Illuminati. So now they're making fun. This is their little parody about it here. And he's like, you know, you watching them, but they really watching you. You know, like, yeah. Or you think you watching them, but they really watching you. I mean, it is what it is. That's what's going on. The government is watching us, what we're doing through these phones, okay? These computers, these television and all these things, man, through these gadgets that we have. They are watching and spying on people that are waking up and pushing this truth out. And that's why they're making fun here in the films to dumb it down, okay? So when we start talking like this, the regular folks who don't have a clue will be like, ah, shut up, you stupid, and XYZ. Right here, it's another film.
That probably ain't even a real nigga. Hey.
Are you on crack? It's Skype.
Ooh, boy, it's hard to be woke. It's hard to be woke.
You see that? Again, like I said, making fun of the awakening of so-called black people. All right? That's what they're doing here in these films. That's what they're doing here in this movie, Bird Box, at this particular point in the movie with this brother here. And this is what I'm showing y'all. So let's get back.
I mean, the internet. I mean, it's where you get all your information from. I'm working on a novel, guys.
Oh.
Fuck.
Hey, wait, hold on. So we can't do anything but just wait here until we go crazy like him?
So back to this scene here where she's asking him about, you know, did he learn that in college? And he said, no, he learned it from the internet. So we get all your information from. Then the other guy, he's like, you know, this guy is sick. And then you hear another voice, I guess it's the other white boy in the background. He says, you know, so we're just supposed to wait here till we go crazy like him. All right, they have him saying it loud enough for people to hear. All right, we're just supposed to wait here till we go crazy like him.
Fuck. Hey, wait, hold on. So we can't do anything but just wait here until we go crazy like him.
Fuck.
Hey, wait, hold on. So we can't do anything but just wait here until we go crazy like him.
So he's the crazy black man in the movie because he's talking this information, right? Just like I showed y'all in the movie Get Out when he said, "I know this is gonna sound crazy." Okay, he's the crazy black man in the film. And of course, like the other film I showed y'all, Night School, Kevin Hart. All right, this brother is crazy. We're all crazy. Me exposing this movie here, Bird Box, is crazy. The stuff I'm showing, it is crazy. Yes, it is crazy. Because the truth is stranger than fiction. It is what it is.
And don't ever say that I don't do nothing for you.
Now, I showed y'all in plenty movie breakdowns that we would be a mocking to all countries. Okay, but I want to go to a scripture here about these mockers. Ecclesiasticus chapter 27, verse 28. Mockery and reproach are from the proud. Okay, these people that make these films. Okay, but vengeance is going to be vengeance behind this. Okay, making fun of us and all of that. As a lion shall lie in wait for them. Okay, so let them mock, let them make fun. It's all good. And this is why they are preparing themselves to fight us, because they know the Most High is going to bring vengeance for what they have done to us. So, as you see here, this dark spirit that passed by, I just want to connect that with scripture, Job chapter 1, verse 7. And the Most High said unto Satan, whence comest thou? Where are you coming from? Then Satan answered the Most High and said, from going to and fro in the earth, and from walking up and down it. And that's what you see here, this dark spirit, okay, this evil spirit, like I brought up in the beginning. Okay, walking to and fro, up and down the earth. So this movie is based on a lot of scriptural things, okay, on truth of the matter, okay?
But if you are listening, from what I can gather, as long as you stay indoors, as long as you don't look at those things, you should be fine.
Now, you see here, the guy was on the radio, he was saying, you know, as long as you don't look at those things, you should be fine. As long as you don't look at those things. Now, I showed y'all previously in the movie The Fourth Kind, you know, the guy that killed his family. He was like, you know, if you saw, you know, if you seen what I saw.
And if you saw what I saw, you would understand.
What did you see, Tommy?
It doesn't matter, because we're not going to have to see it.
Basically, that made this thing that made him basically kill his family, this evil spirit. Okay, which also connects to another movie called People Under the Stairs. This is a throwback film, okay, where the boy was looking at this thing that said, see no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil.
This place is weird.
See no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil.
Okay, also, which connects to another film, The Crazies, where they had the only brother in this movie who was playing a pastor, and then they had him with his eyes and his mouth stitched closed.
Jesus Christ. This place is weird.
See no evil, hear no evil.
See no evil, speak no evil, hear no evil. Okay, as long as you don't look at those things, you should be fine. And this is why they were wearing, they're going to be wearing blindfolds in this film here. Okay, see no evil, speak no evil. All right, all connected.
Digitized signal. It just shows the color temperatures of the objects. It's neutered information. It just colors on a flat screen.
Yeah, but an image can still have power. We have no idea how these things can operate.
Here she said, an image can still have power. Interesting. People can still be demonically possessed by images. And if we just think about the image of white Jesus, how people are so demonically possessed over white Jesus, even though the Bible that they claim to believe in doesn't even depict him as a white man, shows you how demonically possessed people can be over an image.
Mama, couldn't we at least let black Jesus hang alongside?
Forget it. The only Jesus I know is him, and the one thing he don't need is a partner.
Mama, how do we know Jesus wasn't black? He could have been from the lost tribe of Israel. They were supposed to be black.
I bet they were. If ever people were lost, we're it.
Now just hush up, both of you. This picture has been in my family for as long as I can remember. When I was a baby, I don't know what I saw first. My mama, my papa, or this Jesus. Now he's the one I know and love, so let's close the subject.
Yeah, but an image can still have power. We have no idea how these things can operate.
An image can still have power. Wow. Think about that one right there. That is super huge. Now, before I show this next clip, I just want to say that he did mention, when he started talking about the end game, all right, and talking about these demons and all that, after he had mentioned how, you know, he got his information from the internet, he did say he was working on a novel.
I'm working on a novel, guys.
Okay, I didn't mention that, but I'm mentioning it now before I show this scene. At that particular time in the movie, he said he was working on a novel. So now let's get into this scene here about his novel.
It's about the end of the world. My novel.
So notice what's going on here. She picks up the book. All right. She picks up this book off the counter. And then he said automatically, it's about the end of the world. And then he says, it's his novel.
My novel.
Interesting. Remember I showed y'all, or remember I just mentioned that he said he's working on a novel. Okay. And this novel's about the end of the world. Okay. He wrote this book. Okay, because quiet as kept, he is playing Christ in this film. Also, both of these brothers are playing Christ in this movie at different times for different reasons. Okay, because the Mashiach is a reflection of his people. Okay, the people of color are a reflection of the Mashiach, because we are fulfilling prophecy. Okay, and they even said that in the movie Shaka Zulu. Okay, how these people who they put in chains are a reflection of the Messiah, a future prophecy. Okay, it's time to wake up, y'all.
It's not one of those kids' stories, you know, where they all got crossbows and they're killing each other to survive or running around some giant maze. No, this story is gonna be real.
So as he's talking about this novel here, he mentions that it's not gonna be one of those kid stories, you know, about with them running around with arrows and some maze, you know, like the movie The Mockingbird and all that, which those movies are very symbolic and shows a lot of end time prophecy in those movies if you really watch those films, okay? But he said, no, this one here, this one is gonna be real. Confirming that his novel, which is about the end of the world, is based off of truth. It is representing the Bible here.
These books are for white folks, but I do have a special one just for you. It's the best book ever written. Genesis. In the beginning.
I'm working on a novel, guys. No, this story is
the story's gonna be real.
End time prophecy here. And that's why they made him say it in that tone and in that manner that, no, this is going to be real.
The story's going to be real.
So Hollywood knows that the Bible, the scriptures, which is written by black people, okay, is the truth. And it's going to be real. Okay, even though they're clowning us, this is right here, they're being serious. That this brother's novel, because he's representing Christ, like I said. All right? They understand that very well. We got to see these things. This is what we got to pay attention to. But they're giving us clarity right here.
Take your goddamn blindfold off!
Now, in this scene, he's trying to get her to take her blindfold off because, once again, we know if you look at these things, you will basically be demonically possessed by these evil spirits. Okay? This is how people are dying or killing themselves or killing their own families, as I showed you in the movie The Fourth Kind. Okay? So, let's see.
I've seen the truth. Take your blindfold off. Beautiful, take your blindfold off.
They say he's seen the truth. Now, we that are actually in truth understand that the truth is the Most High's law. But he's saying he's seen the truth. Okay, the evil that is walking to and fro among the earth. He has seen the truth, and to him, it's a beautiful thing, okay? With a lot of us, seeing this evil, the evil that you really don't see, he has seen it, and he loves it. But a lot of people today can't see it because evil is the norm. Evil is normal today. Now, as she was chopping him up, chopping him down, okay, he said, it shall cleanse the world. It shall cleanse the world. Wow. Kind of like that blood baptism homie was talking about, right? Interesting. It shall cleanse the world. Everyone must look. Everyone must see this evil. Okay, this evil that's floating in this world, okay? It's such a good thing. But let's make some connections here in the scriptures, okay, about this evil. And we know the Most High says here in Amos 5:15, hate the evil and love the good, okay? Hate the evil and love the good. But here they're telling you to love this evil, okay? It shall cleanse the world. Everyone must look, okay? And establish judgment in the gate. We don't have any judgment. We okay with everything, you know. Guy want to be gay, let him be gay. You know, it's his thing. You know, it's okay. You can't judge anybody, right? Yeah. It may be that the Most High of Hosts will be gracious unto the remnant of Joseph. Let's go here. Isaiah 5:20. Woe unto them that call evil good. All right, take your blindfold off. Take your blindfold off. Because they're calling evil good. Okay, woe unto them that call evil good and good evil, that put darkness for light. Take your blindfold off. Everyone must look and see this evil, this darkness, okay? And light for darkness, that put bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter. So Most High says destruction to these people. And your society is built off of darkness, okay? But people don't understand that the Most High has created this. Okay, the Most High has created the evil for those that love evil. Okay, and that's why it's going to cleanse the world in a sense. Because the Most High is going to bring evil upon people. Get it? Isaiah 45:7. I form the light, create darkness. I make peace and create evil. I, the Most High, do all these things. He does all those things. Okay, but let's get an example. 1 Samuel chapter 19 and verse 9. And the evil spirit from the Most High was upon Saul as he sat in his house with his javelin in his hand, and David played with his hand. Okay, that's when the Most High put the evil spirit upon Saul against King David. Okay, here's another example. Judges chapter 9, verse 23. Then the Most High sent an evil spirit, okay, between Abimelech and the men of Shechem. And the men of Shechem dwelt treacherously with Abimelech. So we see the Most High here sending the evil spirit. Okay, or the evil spirit coming from the Most High. So, who is really in control behind this thing here? Something really deep. Okay, that's what the Most High says, fear him. The beginning of wisdom starts with the Most High.
Is if we can black out all the windows, it's efficient and it's safe.
Wait, is anybody else hearing this? How is driving blind safer?
Right. Notice what he said. Is anybody hearing this? Are you listening, folks? Okay. How is driving blind safe? It connects to the scriptures. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. For we walk by faith, not by sight. And that's what that scene is representing here. How is driving blind safe? Walk by faith, not by sight. Okay, I told you these two brothers here are playing and representing Christ, representing the Word, which they know is black, quote unquote. All right, but you're going to see a lot more of this. Now, one thing you should notice is the brother is driving the car, okay? The brother is driving the car. Interesting. Okay, walk by faith, not by sight. And this is a funny thing that Christians always say, silly Christians. Oh, let Jesus take the wheel, right? Oh, let's just let Jesus take the wheel. Everything will be all right. Just let him take the wheel. This brother here is playing the one they call Jesus Christ. And he is taking the wheel here. Symbolic message. He is the one that's leading them. Think about that.
You have arrived.
So they finally get to their destination. Okay. They finally get to where they need to be. Once again, the brother who is playing the one they call Christ, even though both of these brothers are playing Christ here. However, the writers of this film want to use them, you're going to see these messages, okay, pertaining to people of color as being these symbolic messages in this film here.
Couple paces up, man.
Lost.
Towards your left.
Left. Left.
Here. Okay.
Okay. You're in?
No.
Okay, wait. Almost got it. Okay, I got it.
So again, huge symbolic message here. Okay, the brother was leading the way. The voice you heard from the heavyset brother and the other slimmer brother was in the front. He was the head playing Christ, okay, following the word, following the command. They both and they were led to open the door. And you see both of them unlocking the door, okay? These brothers here, okay? Let Jesus take the wheel, okay? Black man leading them. Okay, why is that though? Why is this film showing that? We gotta look deeper because everything is a symbolic message. And since these devils understand quite clear that the black man is the Mashiach, okay, they know that the Mashiach is a man of color, and that the Most High's people are people of color. There you go.
Jesus was not born in a manger in central Pennsylvania. He was a man of color. He was a man of color.
Where are the canned goods?
Aisle 2.
Toilet paper?
5.
Hooked up. Where's the booze?
It's a 7. Let's not forget, we have limited space. Stick to non-perishable.
So as we see here, it was a brother who led them to the food. Okay? Christ take the wheel. Black man took the wheel. Led them. Okay? By faith. By faith. Because they had the windows painted black. Blacked out. Okay? So they will not see this evil. Okay? See no evil, hear no evil. And he led them to food and safety. But yet, they hate the black man today. So what is this showing y'all? For the Europeans that follow me, what is this saying here? What is this showing you? Huge message. And this is what's going to happen in the end. Okay? The nations are going to follow the real biblical people. Message.
My baby shower gift to you. My sister's expecting a fourth. So.
Oh my God. She's a saint.
Yeah, she is.
So, if you listen really carefully, he gives her a gift, okay, and then she says, your sister, she's a saint. Talking to the guy that's playing Christ, okay? He said, your sister, she's a saint. Okay, and he's like, yeah, she is. Interesting that they say that. She's a saint, huh? Really? Psalms 148, verse 14. He also exalteth the horn or the power of his people, the praise of all his saints, even of the children of Israel, a people near unto him. Praise ye the Most High. See, and I recently went to the museum, Russian icons, and I was showing these saints, and they were people of color. They know that the black people whom they hate so much are the saints. And this is why they hate them so much, because they hate God or the Most High. That's why they worship evil, and they hate that which is good or comes from good. Think about that. Interesting.
Charlie, what's behind there?
It's a loading dock.
Hello?
Now, this is a huge, huge scene in the movie, okay? Here, while they're in the supermarket, okay, they get to this freezer, which behind it is a loading dock, okay? And you have somebody in there. Now, notice they pushed the bird cage, okay, up to where the scene is, okay? Then, also, you heard him say, please let me out of here. And then you're going to hear him say, please let me in.
Please open the doors, let me in.
Cover your eyes.
What?
I'm gonna open the door.
No!
There's a person out there. I have to open the door.
So once again, he says, please let me in. Typically, when somebody's locked in a place, they say, please let me out. So why is he saying, let me in? Because he is demonically possessed. And typically, these demons, they want to get in. Okay? They want to get in. Just like Denzel Washington said in the movie Roman J. Israel.
Well, they wouldn't want to hear it.
Hear what?
The real enemies aren't outside, they're within.
Please open the doors, let me in.
The real enemies aren't outside, they're within.
Okay. The real demons are in the inside. Alright? Please let me in.
Please let me in, I'm trapped.
Wait. It's a fish finger, is that you?
Charlie, it's me, Charlie.
Who's fish finger, Charlie?
He works here at the supermarket.
So Charlie recognizes the person as one of his co-workers here in the supermarket. Also, notice the birds are starting to get a little frantic.
Yeah, they tricked me.
Who's they?
What are you talking about? Are you there alone?
They tricked me and they left me to rot here.
Who left you to rot? What are you talking about?
You guys.
Oh my gosh. He said, who's they? Who's they? We know who they are. These demons, these demonic forces. That's who they is.
The real enemies aren't outside, they're within.
What are you talking about?
You guys, there's something wrong. There's something wrong.
Please let me in. I'm strapped.
Hey, what are you doing, bitch?
So now you see here, Sandra Bullock, she's like, there's something wrong, there's something wrong. We see the birds in the cage, okay? They're going crazy. They're going crazy right now. Why? Because of this demonic presence that's around, okay? Like I said, these animals, they can sense spirits, okay? They are more connected to the spiritual realm than we are. All right, and that's where they're going crazy right now, because this demonic entity that's possessing this guy here in the freezer, which connects to another film to confirm this is true, in the movie Silent Hill.
You guys, there's something wrong.
When they were going after the woman, they brought the birds with them. Okay, because typically in this movie, the sun would go down, everything would just get dark, and that would suggest or let them know that evil presence is now around. Okay, Satan is now walking around, and they would have to run towards the church. Okay, but they carried the birds with them to help indicate when that presence or that evil spirit was around, and that they can know when to flee. Okay, sort of like what's going on here in the movie Bird Box. Hello, birds in a box. Why? Because of this spiritual situation here, suggesting when the evil spirit is around. And that's why she said something's wrong. How did she know? Because of the birds. They would have never known. You know, he's talking all night. So they let me in. But the birds are giving it away. Just like the birds did in the movie Silent Hill. And that's where they dipped. They left.
Let it in. I want you to see it. Let it in.
So now the guy is trying to escape, the guy that's demonically possessed, he's trying to escape, and everybody seems to be preoccupied. Now the camera's on Charlie, he's like a deer in headlights, he's lost, he's frozen, he don't know what to do. Okay, this is his friend, and he's just trying to figure out what to do now in this situation. The birds are going crazy. What shall he do? What would Christ do? What would Jesus do, right? They always say that, right? It's so perfect for me to say that right now. What would Jesus do in this situation? Well, let's see. So Charlie just ran in there with this demonically possessed dude, okay? This guy got demons all in him, okay? And Charlie, who is playing the one they call Christ, as I told y'all, okay, what would Jesus do? Okay, he ran in there, all right? That's what would Jesus do.
Charlie! Charlie!
Charlie!
So as we see, or we can hear and see, that Charlie sacrificed himself for the people. That's what the Mashiach would do. Okay, even though we know he killed himself. Okay, for the children of Israel. Okay. But as you see, the Mashiach, or Charlie, Charlie sacrificed himself here. Okay, Colossians chapter 1, verse 14, in whom we have redeemed a redemption through his blood. And that's why the camera closed up and they showed his blood being spilled here. Sacrifice. Even the forgiveness of sins. Okay, so Charlie sacrificed himself for everyone. Okay, like the Mashiach. Okay, symbolic message here, guys. Once again, these people are showing us whom we are. We just gotta pick it up. And they're gonna keep doing it, because what I'm saying is true, and they're just gonna keep confirming in all these films here.
Look at all this stuff. Birdies? Yeah, they seem to sense when the creatures are around.
So she just confirmed what I basically was saying about the birds. You know, they sense when the creatures are around or the evil spirits are around, which once again connects back to the other movie, Silent Hill, where they were showing that same concept, okay? But check what he says here.
Where's Charlie?
Another novel I won't have to read.
He saved us! He saved us, you fucking asshole!
So when she asked, where is Charlie, and then the other white guy said, another novel, or the Bible, basically, everyone has to read. And then Sandra Bullock turns around and said, he saved us.
He saved us.
He saved us. Okay, again, going back to the Mashiach, the one they call Christ. Okay, he was that sacrifice, okay, for the people. Okay, biblical here. Once again, the black man is representing the Christ. Okay, the Mashiach. Okay, also connects to another movie, Planet of the Apes, War for the Planet of the Apes. Excuse me, I'm sorry. I am so sorry. Not that movie. Well, that movie as well, because in that movie, Planet of the Apes, when the ape was being strung up on a tree, you'll see this in the subtitles. She was saying, you saved us. So, yeah, that movie too, but also another film of the first Purge. Okay, I exposed that movie as well, where at the end, after he had saved everybody, okay, from the military that was coming in to kill black folks, the dude said, you saved us, baby.
Stay strong, y'all.
Back up.
Way to go, Jimmy.
Are y'all deaf?
Save this baby.
Deaf?
Save this baby.
Deaf?
Save this baby.
He saved us, you deaf?
Save this baby.
You saved us. Again, confirming what we're seeing here, okay, what she said, okay, he saved us. He saved us, the black man. The Negro that everybody hates, but he's the one
he saved us,
that saved the Christ, the Mashiach, okay? So, they know what's up. So, at this part in the movie, he has this book with all these demonic images, right? All these demonic pictures and stuff here. Now remember when Sandra Bullock, she said an image can still have power.
Information, it just colors on a flat screen.
Yeah, but an image can still have power. We have no idea how these things can operate.
An image can still have power. Like I said, that image of the false white Jesus has had power over the black community and over the world. Pretty much. So many people are demonically possessed by that image because they believe that to be the truth, which it is far from the truth, which is in the scriptures. But anyway, an image can still have power. So now, after pulling out all these images and he's looking at it, he gets demonically possessed. Okay? He is now demon possessed by these images because, like she said, an image can still have power. And that's how he was able to become demonically possessed in the crib. It's like, okay, well, how did he get demonically possessed? By these images. Which connects back to the movie I showed, People Under the Stairs, where it said, see no evil, hear no evil, okay? What you see becoming demonically possessed.
Yeah, but an image can still have power. We have no idea how these things can operate.
This place is weird.
See no evil, hear no evil, speak no.
What are you doing? What?
So since he has become demonically possessed, demon possessed, okay, he has now understood that these birds can sense demons or the spiritual world, okay? Like I said, that the animals are more connected to the spiritual world than a regular human person, okay? And that's why he's putting the birds in the fridge here. Okay, so that you won't pick up when there's a demonic presence in the house. Because that's what these birds are representing here, okay? Giving you a sign that there's a demonic presence in the home here. So now this clown then got upstairs to where the babies are at. With Sandra Bullock and Olivia, and he's removing the cover from the window so that they can see these evil spirits, okay, to get demonically possessed, okay? That's what's going on here.
Olivia, let me see your baby.
So now Olivia... She then became demonically possessed and ran and jumped out the window, killed herself. Jumped out the window and killed herself. Just like Sandra Bullock's sister, you know, when she said, what the is that? Okay. Filled with this demonic spirit and killed herself. And then the other woman, okay, who killed herself. Okay. Just like I showed y'all in the movie The Fourth Kind, where the guy, he killed himself and his family because of what they saw. If you saw what I saw, that's what he was saying. See this evil. Okay? See. All right? It got in her. She killed herself. Just like the movie Roman J. Israel, where Denzel said, the real demons are in the inside. The inside.
No, no, no.
See.
No.
Now in this part here, he grabs the old lady and he makes her see. He forces her to see, okay? To see this evil. Okay, that's going on in the earth. That's influencing man. See this thing here. Okay, but let's go here into the scripture. 1 John chapter 2, verse 16. For all that is in the world, see the lust of the flesh. See. And the lust of the eye. See. And the pride of life is not of the Father, the Most High, but is of the world, okay? The world, Okay, and the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. Okay, the earth is given into the hands of the wicked, and we know the devil is in control. Okay, the devil is, the Most High is in control, but the Most High is allowing the devil to have control right now for those that want to see. And what did she do after she saw? She killed herself. He didn't do it. He just helped her see. And she killed herself. Just like the movie, Fourth Kind. He saw what he saw, and it made him want to kill himself and his family.
Hey, Mallory. Give me the children. Give me the kids.
Now you see here in the part where he's like, give me the kids, okay? Give me the kids, give me the children. Why? Why is that? Because he wants to sacrifice them, okay? He wants to sacrifice them. Just like in the movie, The Bright movie, okay? When they went after the babies, okay? The babies.
Give me the children. Give me the kids.
Just like he's saying right here. Give me the kids. They're going after the babies. These devils. These devil worshipers. Okay, who make sacrifices to these demons like Molech. Okay, they sacrifice these kids, these children, these babies to these demons. So Hollywood is very aware of this thing. They're very aware of this thing, and this happens all the time, and that's why you have kids battling back in a milk carton, and these kids just end up missing. Okay, because this is a thing that they do regularly because they worship these evil spirits, these evil entities.
Give me the children, or I'll take them.
Hey, asshole!
Hey.
I'm sorry, that was like the funniest part in the movie for me, when he called him an asshole and he just slid over there. That was just too funny, yo.
Hello? Who's this?
My name is Rick. Who is this?
Rick, this is Tom.
So now they get a call on the radio, okay? This guy, he's calling on the radio, and Tom, okay, his name is Tom. This is the brother's name here. His name is Tom, even though, like I told y'all, he is representing the one they call Christ in this film. But basically, he's trying to find out who is this, right? Okay.
Where are you?
Don't answer that.
Near Pike's Quarry.
Jesus, you're a ways away. Jesus, you're a ways away.
Now, this part is big here because they always do this. In many films I've shown, they have done this. They're very slick. They are so slick. Now, you see where he was telling them, you know, where are you? We're ways away. Mind you, he told him his name already. And then he told him Pike's Quarry or whatever, right? And then he said, Jesus, immediately. He said, Jesus. Pause for a second. He said, you're ways away. Okay, pause for a second and say your ways away. But he said Jesus. He called them Jesus because they do that in so many other films. It's their best way of telling you the quote-unquote black man is Jesus. It's their best way. Because it's like you would think, oh, it's normal to somebody just say, oh, Jesus. Jesus, man. But they use that to their advantage. And that's what they're doing right here, being so slick and so crafty. Soon as he told him where he was at, he said, Jesus. Then he said, your ways away. As if to separate that. But here's another example in another film, just so you see I'm not crazy here. And Roman J. Israel showed this before in the movie Roman J. Israel with Denzel Washington. He was calling him Jesus.
Let me tell you about it, George.
No, Jesus, just stop. Roman, enough.
Jesus, you're a ways away. Tell you about it, George.
No, Jesus, just stop.
Jesus Christ.
The images of Jesus that are on prison walls and churches throughout the world are not historically correct, because history teaches us that Jesus was born in a region where the people had color.
Let me tell you about it, George.
No, Jesus, just stop.
And then he was calling him Christ.
Well, I don't have to explain any of this to you. You get it. Christ, you're going to be right in the middle of it. Christ, you're going to be right in the middle of it. Christ, you're going to be right in the middle of it.
No, Jesus, just stop.
Jesus, you're a ways away.
Okay, so this is what these devils do. Also in the movie Planet of the Apes, they were calling him Jesus.
Jesus Christ, you are impressive.
Jesus, you're a ways away.
Okay, because once again, these apes were representing quote-unquote black people, and quote-unquote black people are representing Christ or the Hebrews. Okay, the real Jews here. They understand that very clear, but they are very crafty, as you can see. Now, the guy over the radio is telling them how to get to where he's at, and he's telling them to take this river and telling them to be careful of this location. Okay, the water's fast there. They have lost some people, right? But check what he says here.
You need to see clearly.
What does that mean?
What do you mean, see clearly?
You will have to look.
Then he says, after saying, we've lost some people, he said, you need to see clearly. Okay, you need to see clearly. And he's like, well, what does that mean? He says, you're going to have to look. You're going to have to look. You're going to have to see, basically. Now, I thought this was kind of metaphorical because, you know, think about it. You need to see clearly. They lost some people. We're losing a lot of people. Many people are lost because they're not looking clearly. They're not looking clearly at what's going on out here in the world. And they are lost. That's why he said we've lost some people. Because at this point, you have to see clearly. You have to look. And it's just like life. And this whole scene of traveling this river, like I mentioned in the beginning, is they're trying to make it to heaven. Okay? They're trying to make it to heaven, trying to get to the kingdom, basically, metaphorically. But you have to see, guys. And that's just like in these movies. Another prime example. In these movies that I exposed these messages, these symbolic messages in this film and in many films. You have to look. You have to see. Okay? So that we wake up and we see what's going on here. The deception, the lies, the hidden truth, the hidden agendas. Okay? You have to see. We've lost some people because they don't see. They are blinded. Okay? They walk this earth blinded by the evil that dwells, that walks up and down the earth. Big message here.
Just like you. Like you. Like you. Now, one day we saw this really, really big oak tree. It was bigger than this house. It was so big. It was so big and old.
So now, this brother here, who is representing Christ, he's talking to these children, okay, keyword children, about this big oak tree, or in connection with the scriptures when it talks about the olive tree, okay? He's talking to them about this big oak tree and how they climbed it. Okay, remember, this is all symbolic message. These people know the scriptures. They're very crafty.
Guess what we did?
Climbed it.
We climbed it. Yes, we climbed it. We climbed it and climbed it until we got to the top. Guess what we saw when we got to the top?
Boy, girl, time for bed.
So now he said, guess what we saw at the top, you know, once they climbed the tree. And then Sandra Bullock, she interrupts him and she says, boy, girl, it's time to go. Now let's go into a scripture here. Luke chapter 18, verses 16 and 17. But Yahusha called them unto him and said, suffer little children to come unto me. Mind you, she interrupted him, cutting him off and trying to take the children away. But here he says, suffer little children to come unto me, okay, and forbid them not. Mind you, she's interrupted his conversation, and she's basically trying to remove the children, okay? For of such is the kingdom of the Most High, the kingdom of God, okay? Verily, I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child shall in no wise enter therein. Okay, you must enter the kingdom of heaven as a child. And that's why they're showing this scene here of him who is representing Christ, a black man, talking to the children. Okay, the children, because the children are very humble and meek, at least most of them. Okay. And they're willing to listen and learn, unlike adults. And that's why it says, suffer the little children, okay? And whomsoever shall not receive the kingdom of the Most High as a little child, okay? You must be like a child. You must be willing to change, okay? You must be willing to learn and not be prideful and stubborn and hard-headed like the world is. But once again, she interrupted them and she called them, okay?
Girl, come on. Right now. Come on. Right now. Bed.
Now here, you see her call a girl, but the little girl refused, which confirms, okay, the symbolic message here, like I showed y'all in the beginning, boy and girl representing Adam and Eve. And you see here, the girl, okay, which is representing Eve, she refused. She's not listening to the mom, okay? She's not listening. Not listening. The woman, the female, okay? Which connects to scripture about Eve not listening, okay? 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 14. And Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived was in transgression. So right here in this part, she called the boy and the girl. The boy came. He listened. But the girl refused. Okay? Right she refused. She did not listen to her mom.
Right now.
Okay, but let's go a little bit more into the story. Into the book of Genesis chapter 3, verse 2 through 5. And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, the Most High hath said, ye shall not eat of it. Neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. Okay, that was the commandment from the Most High. And the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die. Going against what the Most High said. Against the Father, like what these devils do. For God doeth know that in the day ye shall eat thereof, then your eyes see, shall be open. See. And ye shall be as gods. I wonder why they're calling a woman God today. Interesting. Knowing good and evil. Very interesting here. But that's what's going on here. Boy and girl is representing Adam and Eve. Okay? And in their journey to the kingdom of heaven. Okay?
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Now they think they're going to go outside and climb trees it's with all these new Mallory. Kids and see butterflies and flowers and
bullshit.
It's a story,
Mallory.
It's not a story. It's a lie. Because
so now Sandra Bullock wants to have a personal conversation with Tom, who's representing Christ here. And she's like, what are you doing? You're telling them, you're making them think they're going to go climb trees and all this stuff. You know, it's all a lie. Okay? Basically what they're saying, the Bible is not true. And this is what some people say. They say the Bible is not true. Okay, it's all a lie. And this is what, you know, this is basically what they're saying here in this scene.
Make them believe something like that.
Because they have to believe in something. What is this for if they don't have anything to believe in, Mal?
So that they survive.
Surviving is not living, Mal.
Well, they're going to die if they listen to you.
Now, this part was extremely huge. She said, why would you make them believe something like that? And he's like, you know, well, they have to believe in something, basically have some sort of faith. And she says, you know, well, they're going to
die if they listen
to you.
If they listen to you, talking to the black man who's playing Christ. Basically, if you believe in the word of the Most High, they're going to kill you. Symbolic message, just like in the movie The Fifth Wave.
Drop your weapon.
Drop yours first. Drop it.
She came in. She was asking the guy to show his hands. Okay. And when he tried to show his hands. The crucifixion cross that he had, which was representing Christ, even though it's an idol, she shot him. She thought it was a weapon, but she shot him.
What's in your hand?
Okay, because she saw something shiny and silver. She thought it was a gun, so she killed him. That was a symbolic message for those that believe in the cross, symbolic message, representing Christ, symbolic message, all right, they're going to kill you. And that's what she's saying here, okay, well, they're going to die if they listen to you, okay, which also, another movie, big movie connection, huge right here. This is blockbuster, y'all. The movie Dark Tower, when the white man, once again, this white woman here is telling this black man that. And in this film, Dark Tower, all right, the white man said that everyone that walks with you dies.
Everyone who walks with you dies.
Well, they're going to die if they listen to you.
Everyone who walks with you dies. Everyone who walks with you dies.
All right. The white man said that everyone that walks with you dies. Everyone that walks with you dies. Why is he saying that? Because again, in this film, this black brother here was representing Christ. You can watch my breakdown of this whole movie, Dark Tower. And I show it all, just like I'm showing it all here in this movie, Bird Box. They know the black man represents Christ. They know Christ was basically black, what you call a Negro today. They've just stripped us of our heritage, our history, and our language. That's why we don't know nothing anymore. Okay, but once again, this was a huge part in the film. Okay. They're going to die if they listen to you, just like he's saying here. Everyone that walks with you dies.
You haven't given them names, Mal. Their names are boy and girl. Think about that. You haven't given them names, Mal. Their names are boy and girl. Think about that.
Okay. He said, you haven't given them names. Think about that. You haven't given them names. And we know, once again, boy and girl representing Adam and Eve. But he said, you haven't given them names. Think about that. So let's think about that for a second while we get into some scripture here. Proverbs chapter 22 and verse 1. A good name is rather to be chosen than good riches. You see why having a good name is so important? And loving favor rather than silver and gold. So a good name is better than having great riches. Having a good name. Okay, Ecclesiastes chapter 7 and 1. A good name is better than precious ointment. Okay, and the day of death than the day of one's birth. But we're just sticking with that name part. Okay, Ecclesiasticus chapter 41, verse 13. A good life hath but few days, but a good name endureth forever. And that's why he's saying here, you haven't given them names. Think about that. Okay? They understand this wisdom and knowledge. Hollywood, trust me.
You know what I saw at the top of the tree? I saw a nest sitting on the top branch. And then they just flew away.
Now here's another huge part where he gets in the bed with Sandra Bullock. And he He tells her, you know what I saw at the top of the tree? Because he was interrupted. He didn't get a chance to share that with the children, right? And he said he saw a nest of birds, okay? And they flew away, basically, all right? Basically telling her what... Basically, he was prophesying what was going to happen in the end of the movie. That's what he was doing. He was prophesying. Because once again, this black man here, which everybody calls these people of color black and African American, he was representing Christ. He was prophesying what was going to happen. But let's get it here, Revelation chapter 19 and 10. And I fell at his feet to worship him. And he said unto me, see thou do it not, I am thy fellow servant and of thy brethren that have the testimony of the Mashiach. Okay, of Yahushua, worship the Most High. For the testimony of Yahushua, or this word, is the spirit of prophecy. And that's what he was doing here. He was prophesying what was going to happen at the end of the film. Now, of course, as he comes in the crib, lifts up the blindfold, and he's holding it, okay, throwing up a 666 at the same time. This is what Hollywood does in many of their films. They always do that. For those that follow my work, y'all understand, and y'all see this all the time, okay? Now, as they're scavenging through this house, they're in the kitchen, and Sandra, she finds a box of Pop-Tarts here. Okay, now, this is going to be another symbolic message here with these Pop-Tarts. Now, listen to what they say.
Probably stale.
Yeah, just how I like them.
Probably stale.
Yeah, just how I like them.
Now, after she gave him the Pop-Tarts... Okay, she said, they're probably stale, okay? Probably stale. And that's when he turns around and he tells her, you know, that's how I like it.
Just how I like
them. Why? What does that mean? Okay, the stale Pop-Tarts are what? They're no good, right? They're stale. They're no good. Just like the Mashiach. He came for the sinners, which are people that are no good, to have life, basically. Okay, it's all a symbolic message here. Okay, that's why he said, that's how I like them. Why would he like stale Pop-Tarts? That doesn't make any sense. But we know something that's stale means it's no good. So why would he like something that's no good? Because he came for those that are no good to have life. Let's get that in the scriptures, Luke chapter 5, 32. I came not to call the righteous or the good, but sinners, the no good, the stale, to repentance. Okay, that is the symbolic message here. But with wisdom and understanding, we will see these things clearly. We have to see.
To get to the boat and you go.
I'm not leaving you. I'm not leaving you.
Listen, I love you so much.
Now, here in this scene, okay, when the bad guys show up on the scene, he rips a thing off his neck, okay, and gives her this pendant that he had, right? It's a symbolic message here, okay? He gives her that, and he says, I love you, okay? Now, in connection... with another film, okay, Birth of a Nation. Birth of a Nation.
I love you so much.
Right? He did the same thing to the woman that he loved. Okay? Same thing. He gave her this pendant. Okay, this medallion, whatnot, you know? Basically, same thing going on here, okay?
My nana got it from my granddaddy. She brought it with her when she was taken from Africa.
I want you to have it. Listen to me.
I love you so much.
I want you to have it.
Both women that they love, they gave them something in remembrance of them. Okay? Symbolic message here. All right? And we know Israel was known for idolatry or having things like that anyway. Okay?
Two kids over here.
Now, right here in this scene, okay, he was shot in his side. If you didn't notice, he was shot in his side, okay? They caught that nice little slick shot right there, okay? These people are very, very crafty, extremely crafty, okay? The brother was shot in his side. This is what they do all the time, okay? All the time. But let's get it in the scriptures here. John chapter 19, okay, verse 34. But one of the soldiers with a spear pierced his side, okay? Pierced his side. Forthwith came there out blood and water. Pierced his side in connection to the movie Black Panther. That's on my channel. You can check that out, okay, for free, okay, where I showed him getting pierced in his side, okay, one of the soldiers with a spear pierced his side, just like in the movie Black Panther, he pierced his side, okay, in connection with another movie, The Book of Eli, okay, he was shot in his side.
Not all the time.
Just like he was shot in his side here in the Bird Box, okay? Another confirmation, all right? In connection with another movie, Planet of the Apes. Excuse me, War for the Planet of the Apes.
Hello, Roman.
Hi.
This is George Pierce. This is George Pierce. This is George Pierce. This is George Pierce. 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 Pierce.
He was pierced in his side. Again, 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 again. Also, another movie that I just broke down. Okay, you can order that movie as well. The First Purge.
Pierce.
He was shot in his side. Come on now. How many times Hollywood is going to do that? Showing these brothers continuously getting shot in their side, which goes with the scriptures of the one they call Christ, being pierced in his side. In his side, y'all.
Pierce.
How many times are they going to do that to confirm to you that we are the biblical people? The one they call Christ is a black man. And I proved that in another video that you can order, okay, called Russian Icons Exclusive, where I show that they know the Mashiach was a black man. Okay, another connection. The movie Dark Tower.
Pierce.
Okay, he was pierced in both of his hands. Okay, both of his hands. All right, in connection with the scripture, Psalms chapter 22, 16. For dogs have compassed me, the assembly of the wicked have enclosed me. They pierced my hands and my feet. Okay, again, the brother representing Christ here. And all these films, all these connections to confirm that Hollywood understands with the knowledge and the truth of the scriptures and the research that they know black people, Pierce. Whom they call black, are the real Hebrew Israelites, the real Jews of the scriptures, the real chosen people of the Most High God. And this is what they spend their millions on, just to show us this. So we see. As you see here, he's walking, he's hurt, but what? He's holding his side. Holding his side. Confirmation that he was shot in his side. Okay, now you heard a noise, the spirit. Wandering the earth, okay, this evil spirit, he is now in a fight for his own life now, okay, becoming demonically possessed. So, you see here, he fought the spirit, okay, just to shoot the enemy, just to kill the enemy, okay? He fought the evil spirit that was trying to possess him just to kill the bad guy right here. But of course, as you know, he that killeth by the sword must be killed by the sword. And that's why he did this. That's why he had to kill himself. Okay? Because he that liveth by the sword must die by the sword. It's all a symbolic message here. Okay? All a symbolic message here. But you see, these people are dealing with high wisdom and knowledge. This movie's all spiritual. Right? I'm just showing these things. I'm just showing this in the film. All right, but there you go.
I shouldn't have stopped you from playing. I shouldn't have ended Tom's story because it wasn't finished when he.
So now here in this scene, you know, she lost the girl, and she's talking now, trying to find her, and she's basically saying, you know, she shouldn't have cut Tom off. The one that's playing Christ here in the film, okay? Shouldn't have cut him off when he was sharing that story with the children, okay?
Guess what we saw when we got to the top?
Boy, girl, time for bed.
But Tom's telling a story.
Yeah, Ma, let me just, we're almost done.
I'm not going to say it again. Come on.
Shouldn't have cut him off. And that's why the scripture said, suffer not the little children. So now she's getting it. She's seen the wisdom and knowledge here of this brother who's playing the one they call Christ. And she's trying to tell him the end, what he saw, basically. Okay?
When he climbed to the very top of that giant oak tree and he saw birds, all different colored birds.
So now she's confirming what Tom saw at the top of the tree, okay? Seeing all these kids, seeing these birds, X, Y, Z. She is now confirming this now here, okay? She shouldn't have interrupted the man, but now she's making confession okay, of this guy, okay, this black man who is representing the one they call Christ.
He saw us from the very top. He saw us together, and we have to be together. And it's not just a story. It's not.
Now she's saying, you know, he saw us from the top of the tree, okay, him representing Christ, the top of this tree here.
To the very top of that giant oak tree.
He's... So what now?
Okay, he saw us, and it is not just a story. This is the truth here. So when they were making fun of the other brother, okay, about him and his novel, when he was like, oh, not another novel everybody's gonna have to read, okay?
It's about the end of the world.
And it's not just a story. It's not.
This story's gonna be real.
These books are for white folks, but I do have a special one just for you. It's the best book ever written.
It's about the end of the world. My novel.
Making fun because they know this book belongs to the people of color. It's a black man's book. It's not a white man's book here. Okay, the symbolic messages in this film is very clear. But it's only when you understand this type of truth. That's when you'll see that Hollywood knows this very well.
You're inside and you're safe. You can take your blindfolds off.
So they're finally inside and they are safe, okay? And they took their blindfolds off and there's a plaque on the wall that says School for the Blind. Interesting. Interesting. So this kingdom of heaven will be like school for the blind, because basically the blind is basically going to be those that are going to make it in the kingdom of heaven. Those who have been blind to this wickedness in the world. And that's why it says you must see. If you're going to make it, you got to see. You got to be able to tell the difference between good and evil. Okay, you have to see the wickedness. And I don't mean see as in do, okay, see and love it, but have the wisdom and knowledge to understand the difference and to choose that right path, okay? So in essence, you have to be blinded to the wicked in order to make it to the kingdom of heaven here. And basically, the blind is going to be those that's going to make it, because majority of people are too blind to see the truth of the wickedness in the world because they love it so much. So now he's taking them to show them the kingdom of heaven, this place, all right, where majority of the people are blind. Because the majority of the people that are going to make it to this kingdom of heaven is going to be blind unless they have eyes to see the truth. See the truth. Okay?
Your name is Olivia. And your name? Your name is Tom.
So now she gives boy and girl names now, finally. Why? Because now she has some sort of wisdom in her after sleeping with a black man. I mean, learning from a black man, okay, who is representing the one they call Christ, okay? Now she has the wisdom and knowledge and understanding, all right? That's why she's now giving them names.
Hey,
So in the end, she sees all the kids playing like Tom told her, okay? And we see this oak tree here, all right? And then she looks up and she sees the birds. All right, she sees the birds fly away, basically. Everything that Tom said to her, all right, happened the way he said it would happen, okay? Because he was prophesying the future or prophesying the end of this movie here.
You know what I saw at the top of the tree? I saw a nest sitting on the top branch. Then they just flew away.
Confirming that this brother was playing and representing the one they call Christ or the Jesus, okay? Yahushua HaMashiach, okay? Black man, black brother here, okay? So who are we? We are the children of the Most High God, okay? The real Hebrew Israelites, the real Jews whom were black people.
Do you know that the black man in America is Israel? That he's Jews? Do you know that?
Yes.
Hollywood knows this. It's in so many films. And I'll be doing another separate video that I'll be showing about 50-something movies to confirm Hollywood does know this. So, anyways, thank you for watching the film. Hope you enjoyed the breakdown. Until the next one. On that note, I'm going to say peace and shalom, family.